How was the training program? 1 to 5? 5? 4.8 or 4.9? No, be honest. Yes. Right. 4.4. Okay. Now Rajori. Rajori, can you please raise your hands? I think 20. Somewhere. 20 numbers. 19. Great, great. So Rajori is a small place? No, border is okay. Nowadays there are no borders. So it's a small place. District place. How much is the population?
It's one of the oldest districts.
Okay. So Rajori, out of these 19, how many are from other state? Oh, large number. Great. Okay. So you like this place? Anybody? These many? Those who are from outside and like this place. Oh, so many. Yes. Can I have a notepad? A notepad? No, no, no. Not for wrongdoing or wrong purpose. It is for good reason. I am going to request you to note down your name, your mail ID, your contact number and home state. Right? Those four people. Right? The other institute is? Science and Technology. Other institute, yes. Science and Technology,
Islamic University of Science and Technology.
Islamic University. So Islamic University, can you please raise your hands? Okay, thank you. Those who are not from that state, 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, good. So this Islamic University, can you please raise those 5 6 people raise your hands, please? Yeah. No, only these 4 5. Those who like this Rajori and not from that state. Rajori, I said, not students, not your principal, not your the institute, your this thing. Rajori place you like. You would like to serve this place. What I want? Your name, your mail ID, contact number. And your home state, right? Okay. So, can you please again, once again, I request you to raise your hands, those who like Islamic, this area, who are not from that state. Yes. So, you like this place very much, right? In other words, you would like to serve this place. Place, I said place, right? Okay. So, I will pass on that register to you also, right? The third institute is? Mujaffarpur. Mujaffarpur, hear it. So, Bihar, right? Can you please raise your hands? So, maybe somewhere 15. Now, from, not from Bihar, please keep your hands raised. Not from Bihar. Now, out of these, who like this Mujaffarpur more? Nobody? No problem, no problem. There is no issue as such. You like means you will not be allowed to resign, you will not be allowed to run away, you will not be allowed to get transferred, shifted. No such objective. Objective is something different. I would like to understand from you, because yesterday there was a press conference given by our honorable. So you must have gone through. It was basically for you, my dear friends. And he put it before all correspondents, that is the correspondents, I mean press people, that these people, majority they have taken up this job just to serve such a places which are you know not reported, not touched by the candidates from you know well placed areas. You know, we have Kerala students, 34 students, 34 candidates from Kerala serving Bihar, Odisha, Uttarakhand and maybe few in J&K and Northeast. Kerala, right. So, this is what they know. It is not only the package and the salary you get, but also you think that there are many things which you can gain through this project, right. So, can you please pass on that register moment yours is over. I want just 4 or 5 names here, that is all, 4 or 5 names. I will call you and then I will have discussion why I have collected your names, right, very shortly, maybe next within a week. And I am collecting these names from all other places. You know, these trainings are happening, workshops are happening at 7 different IITs in different installments. So, I had been to IIT Bombay, I had been to IIT Hyderabad, IIT Indore, IIT Kanpur, shortly IIT Kharagpur. So, all IITs almost once, because this is the second batch here, already first batch is over. And I thought let us see how the things are happening, and that is why I have asked you rating. So, it was just honest, otherwise you are putting your feedback and God knows how do you give your feedback. Now, my objective here, is to explain you first of all the purpose of your recruitment, your engagement. You know little bit of it, because that is available in your engagement later. You must have gone through some bond also, something like agreement, everything you have written. You can ask so many questions, but after lunch, not now. I have about 35-36 slides. Out of 36, I have to finish 30 before lunch. So, I would request you to curtail down your lunch also. Instead of 1 hour, it should be 45 minutes, I think enough. Only the queue is a problem, so I think just find out solution. Because anyhow, I have to leave here by 3:15. And I keep this question answer session end, at the end. Either questions will get reduced, number of questions, or you will speed up your lunch. So, only 2 options. So, the first part is the object is the purpose, and that is a project. Your recruitment is only for project, you know that, you have been informed that. Every now and then in all bulletins, yesterday press conference as well, all these questions were asked by the press reporters, all were answered by only minister, not by me. Because conceptually government of India and everybody is very, very clear as to what is what. But I am going to tell you some good things of joining this project, taking up this. Even somebody has come on lean, you know, deputation from your parent organization, it is going to be useful and beneficial to you. This is what the project is. What is the project? No, every one of us should know this. Yes, what is the project? Tech Cube. What is Tech Cube?
Technical Education Quality Improvement Program.
Very good. And you are called as?
Faculty.
You are faculty for Tech Cube 3. We wanted to give you some pedagogy. teaching learning process, explaining you the objectives, explaining you the purpose of the project, and explaining you what teaching learning process means. Many of you might have been teacher, working as a teacher somewhere. Let us try to, for the time being, forget what was that, but we wanted to give you all exposure of IIT for understanding what is teaching learning process. The opportunity which you won't have got maybe throughout your life. And this has happened only in very first month. Few people yesterday joined, today started his journey. This is what the idea was, but it's not end, it's going to continue. You are going to get so many benefits, so many opportunities of visiting such organizations. Don't think that such organizations are available only abroad. Abroad for education is okay, abroad for employment, recruitment, appointment is okay. But as far as education is concerned, it is better to take education in our own motherland, better to serve our own motherland. So, this is that project. Whether it is visible? Should I switch off some lights? Yeah, because this I think is will be made available to you. So, it is not necessary to, where are the lights? Yeah. Oh, sorry, extremely sorry, extremely sorry. I have seen 6 logos there out, but still I was thinking that, you know, this is the second, so I said 3 are 3 3. Okay, sorry. So Lok Nayak. So please raise your hands. Oh my God, great. So, I think I would have missed like majority, right? Chapra, yeah. Because I was just remembering while just preparing for the presentation, Chapra, Chapra, and only Chapra. So, I am Central Project Advisor, my dear Chapra friends. Central Project Advisor for this project, which comes under MHRD. Project is World Bank and Government of India collaboration, 50-50 collaboration. Implementer, for implementation I am responsible for entire country. We have units at every different state which we call as State Project Implementation Unit. We are NPIU, National Project. Present, we are located at Noida, shall be shifted shortly to New Delhi. Noida, New Delhi, hardly 5 kilometers distance. So, we will be shifting to the new location very shortly. In my office, there is no permanent person. My office, everybody is contract, including me. I am also contract, I have come for this project only for the period of 3 years. I am also on contract. I am Central Project Advisor, my immediate authority is Secretary, Human, MHRD, Higher Education, Technical Education. My immediate boss is Secretary and his immediate boss is Minister. This is the organization. But I have come on deputation from some state. I have taken leave for 3 years. My state said, yes, go there and work for the nation, only restricting yourself to state, please go there. And that's why I have come here. Recently, June 2017, I joined here. Otherwise, I am a principal of one of such government engineering college in the state, some state. Some state. State in the country. So, I am principal and I have been principal since 2003. So, last 14 years I have an experience of working as a principal. I was a principal in 2003 when this TechCube 1 was started, and that institute was also part of TechCube 1. TechCube 1, there were 127 institutions from 13 states. CFIs is also mentioned, that is centrally funded institutions. These are all National Institute of Technologies, NITs. So, I was one amongst 127. My institution was selected because that institution had some quality. It was through challenge method. Not that anybody writes application and gets selected, just like your engagement. It was not simply writing the application and getting selection, I mean selection offer. It was not like that. It was through challenge method, through interview. Interviews were conducted. We were supposed to score some number of marks on a 100 scale. We could score, and that is why we got selected in TechCube 1. This is a story 2003 to 2009. That institution got accredited 60% programs in the year 2007. Before that, no accreditation. 60% programs, all UG programs and 2 PG programs. That institution intake was 330 students. That institution got autonomous status in the year by UGC. In the year 2008, and it all is was possible only because of, remember, what TechCube cannot do. I had similar faculty which you have got in your Rajouri or Chhapra, similar principal, sorry, I was a principal. So, similar faculty. With the same faculty, similar kind of setup, no chairs, no table, you do not have that. Drinking water, somebody was talking about toilets. What more we should say when we are not bothered about hygiene? Same situation, almost, but I came as a through challenge method after scoring some marks. This is a story in the year 2003 to 2009. 2011 I was transferred as a director of that state, director state board of technical education. I will not name state. Whatever you say. So, I was transferred there. Maybe because I have done something good, or maybe opposite. So, was transferred. I took up, no problem, I am ready to go anywhere. 3 years, 3.5 years I was there for state board. And then in the year 2013, I was transferred to another institution which was very much there in the project TechCube 2. Since 2011, but nothing happened in the institution till 2014, February 2014. Till then nothing happened, nothing, literally nothing. No accreditation, no talk on accreditation, no autonomy and no teaching learning process, no expenditure, no procurement and nothing and nothing. Only procurement was done for laptops, computers and printers. And Xerox, photocopy. Try to understand the point. Faculty was there. We had only 47 faculty as against 98 required. 47 faculty. With 47, you cannot get accreditation. With 47, you cannot get autonomy. Nothing. It is not possible. But I did not stop. I have evolved mechanism there, started thinking how to recruit faculty. Remember, my dear friend, faculty recruitment could happen only in Tech Cube 3, no Tech Cube 1, no Tech Cube 2. The reason is some aggression which is required at the top level. For each and everything that top level organization in NPIU or maybe MHRD is responsible for your recruitment, for your engagement. Right from evolving the criteria, eligibility criteria, I will talk to on eligibility criteria a little later. Many complaints, many grievances, many, so many things, and also litigations, no problem. So, 47 went to 95 in 2 years. 47 went to 95 in 2 years. Not only assistant professor, but also associate professor and professor and adjunct professor, professor emeritus. And when I left, even before that, well before that, because my autonomous batch is now in final year. So, you can just go back and calculate. 2000 maybe 15 we got autonomy, 2015 we got autonomy, 2016 we got out of 11 courses, 10 courses accredited. Same faculty, same problems, similar problems, similar type of students, their habits, their interests, everything is same. And therefore, last 14 years I have proved, and I am very much confident that we can change the situation. We can change the situation. We say now the five fingers, you know, these fingers are of different size. You know, these five fingers, out of these five fingers, this finger is always useless, remember. They are all destructive people. Good number, right? This second finger is also useless. They believe in shortcuts. They believe in shortcuts, and closer to this, always destructive. If you want to have driving license, never believe in queue. Give additional 100 rupees, 500 rupees nowadays may have got increased. And get your license without even giving. This is that. Very close. This is always nor here, neither there. He doesn't know who the next flat neighbor is. Doesn't know. Just like this. Restricted to his own family, somebody comes with the idea, he will never respond immediately. He will say, just keep papers with me, I will just go through that and I will let you know. After a week, what has happened, sir? No, I have not gone through. Because he doesn't believe in anything. He doesn't, you know, it's very simplest way, simple person. Second person, we all are. This one, this finger. We belong to this family. We all are dedicated. We know what is wrong, what is right, and we always support right. And he is head of the institution, your principal. Remember, you have to keep him closer to you and not closer to, otherwise, entire thing will get destroyed, total destruction. So, friends, that is all possible. You just try to be nearer to the principal. Try to convince him, repeatedly tell him anything is possible. You can see Tech Cube 3 is something different than Tech Cube 1 and Tech Cube 2. Tech Cube 1, challenge method. Tech Cube 2, challenge method. I was a part of Tech Cube 2 also. My earlier institution was also part of Tech Cube 2 as another component. In the form of another component for PG. We started so many PG programs in that institution. process was started, then somebody next principal continued the same pattern and got selected in take cube 2. But in take cube 3 it is not the case, case is something different. Here all institutions, they are badly in need of such support, not only financial. I normally tell all principals, your principal also, we had meeting of all these 54 principals at Delhi in AICTE on 24th, all principals, and I told them how to, you know, how to handle this faculty. I have given them presentation, some part of that presentation was similar to this, not this, because TechCube etcetera they are aware about. I wanted to tell you what is TechCube, but also how to provide facility, what facilities can be provided under your discretion and what facilities we are providing, that everything has been informed to them so that there won't be any kind of misunderstanding, at least at the stage of principal, because I heard so many things that your senior faculty members are telling you so many different things. I told them and I have given them examples as to what your senior faculty are telling these people. They are asking these people to sit in godowns, no chairs and no tables. Why principal requires such a huge table and so many chairs? Why can't you spare? So everything we have discussed. Time will, let us wait for our time. Time will come and you will prove your importance in the institute. Gradually it will happen, it does not happen in a day, in a month, even in a semester. You have to stay on the wicket, then only you get, otherwise not possible. Just little bit of patience will get you so many things. So that is what the third project is, and you can see how the funding, that 3600 is the amount funding, 3600 crores, 1800 crores from World Bank, 1800 crores from Government of India. Earlier it was not like that, earlier it was 2430, 50-50, 50 state government and 50, and state government was not able to provide money in time to the institutions and institutions, that is why this project got delayed by 7 years. Now this time the project is only for 3 years, September 2020, at the most extension we may get for entire session, maybe 2021, maybe April, May, June, something like that. And we want to achieve all the targets here, so that next project comes, and next project probably will get us additional opportunity. In the meantime we are planning so many other things for you. So what happened, you know, there is exponential increment in the funding pattern also. You can see here 156 institutions and 3600, here it is 191 institutions, 2430. So per institute funding is also increased. Of course the objectives are very clear. What we want is a quality. What is quality? Quality cannot be achieved without faculty. That is what the first question I said, first sentence I uttered in front of my secretary, that sir, quality is not possible without faculty. And after going through the statistical information of these institutions, I find that faculty is very poor. Whosoever is a faculty, quality is also not proper. Even mindset of these people who are working there is also not good, because they have become almost dormant. Am I wrong? It's not the situation, case that, you know, nobody from them are there, so that's why I'm criticizing. I am like this only. I'm very vocal. I told ministry that without faculty it is not possible. Then next question came to me, how can we do that? I said, we can give me 15 days, I will prepare a document and submit. Within 15 days, my dear friends, the advertisement was published. And you know how fast the process. We did not stop for anybody. Maybe litigation, maybe Right to Information Act, maybe complaints, maybe. But because we are sure that we are not doing any corruption as such. Helping the student is not a corruption. By whatever way you help, in legitimate way. When you don't do corruption, I think nobody should worry and nobody should bother about this. So, this is a project. Now, what happened in last project? TechCube 2. Let us not discuss about TechCube 1. We discuss only about TechCube 2. What happened in TechCube 2? There are many achievements. World Bank has declared this project as a very, very successful project. TechCube is only the project of World Bank which has lasted for such a long period throughout the world. 2003 we started, 2017 we will be going to 2020. Today itself it has exceeded all records as far as lasting the project, I mean duration of the project is concerned. Still World Bank has come with, World Bank does not give you funding without any objectives. Please try to understand. World Bank first of all conducts survey. Finds out what are the problems, maybe health, maybe education. So, in technical education, what are the problems? They started with ITIs. If you remember, there were some TechEd projects before 2003. Started with ITIs, then went to polytechnics. Even in TechCube 1, there were few polytechnics included. TechCube 2 only engineering college, TechCube 3 only engineering college. And now this is a focus states, you know what is, what do we mean by focus states? All these states, all these 19 states are having less human development index. You know what is SDI? SDI considers four parameters and one of these four parameters is education, per capita income, health, environment. So, our human development index of these states where you are allotted, where you are deployed, where you are engaged is very, very low. Northeast less than 0.1, all Northeast states. J&K you check, it is available on Google search, human development index. These are all poor states financially. Climate wise you know that, what hardship you have to do. You do not find, you know, flattened land anywhere. He was telling the strata, soil strata, who was telling? I think he was telling. You cannot, you know, construct buildings. Lot of cost is involved. And another point, an important point is border. That is another issue. No, we know only where there is a diversity, there is a life. Remember, only where there are the problems, there is a life. If there is no problem, it is not a life. So, we are located in such a, at such a place. So, what I said, that these are few indicators I have tried to put before you. What happened in TechCube 2? This is a slide. There are about 8 indicators. I have shortlisted 8 indicators, and all these 8 indicators except last 8, rest are related to you as a faculty. What faculty could do in TechCube 2? You are also a faculty, remember. One of my slides will tell you who are you. You are also faculty. I have personally warned all your principals that please treat them as more than faculty, because they are going to be your main, you know, weapons for development. So, all these 7 indicators are related to, yeah, thank you, 7 indicators are related to you. What can you do? First one is number of publications, it has increased. So, you have a scope. All publication charges are admissible under the project. wherever publications. Of course, there should be citations, some impact factor, H index, I index, so and so. Scopus, web page of web of science, so on and so forth. That should be like that, you know, the quality. Whatever amount is required, that is admissible. Whatever consumable cost is required, that is admissible. Whatever and any incidental cost required for doing research in your laboratory, your, I said your laboratory, that is admissible. So, number of publications, can you imagine? We thought, World Bank said it should be 15,000, the baseline data was 7,000, it has gone to 18,400. This is all, these are all cited journals. Second, patents, you can see there was no target as such, but then this is how we have obtained and published. This is filed and this is obtained, 81. We go next, books published, no target, still so many books were published. Number of faculty members benefited from pedagogical training, just similar training. There was a target of 2200, 3750, and this year in TechCube 3 we will be finishing about 1600 in this month only. This is how we are moving. You get an opportunity. Next is a subject domain, again same. Management capacity building, IIMs, I will talk about IIMs little later. Externally funded research, yes, that is also there. So, all these parameters exceeded, you can see. Transition rate, are you aware about transition rate? Phrase transition rate, can you read? I will read for you. Transition rate of all students from first year to second year of undergraduate study. What is transition rate? Pardon? Passing, first year passing. First year students going to second year. What is the average of our country? Yes? 47. 47. Out of 100, only 47 candidates go to second year. Right? In TechCube, what was the achievement? Here it is, 67. Target was, and then 12 number, serial number 12, share of TechCube supported engineering institutions from these areas, low income, northeast, hilly area, it was expected was 20, we got only 19%, and that is the reason why World Bank thought of having only these 19 focus states under consideration for TechCube 3. Now you, our institutions cannot compete in the challenge because we have never gone for accreditation so far. No question of autonomy, hardly few. When this is a situation, how can you get selected? And therefore, MHRD said no selection now. Just adopt them and start. And that is why all these benefits are coming. And everything is going directly to the institutions, lot of flow. Constant persuasion, mentoring, monitoring, and everything is happening. Evaluation, we will do it little later. Because, you know, everybody is having lot of fear about evaluation. We don't want examination. Rest of the things is okay, but examination, lot of fear and fewer. So, 19%. And 13 and 14 is very important. This is accreditation and autonomy. What was the target? You can see 55 was the target, and 63 we achieved for accreditation. 70 was the target for autonomy, exact 70. This time also we have targets, and those targets we have decided to achieve. In a very short span, things are moving very fast. Now, what is a project? In project, basically this project is for focus states. Focus states means all these low income states, hilly area states, northeast, Northeast, there are 8 states. Low income, there are about 5-6 states, and hilly area about 6-7 states. So, like this, total number comes out to be 90. And we are selecting only government and government aided institutions. What about unaided institutions? We have to take care of unaided also, because 92% of the education happens in unaided institutions. And therefore, for considering these unaided institutions, we have these 1.2 component which considers affiliating technical universities. And therefore, in Bihar, one university we have considered, in J&K we have considered one university. These ATUs are there in the project. The function of ATU is different, function of institutions is different. ATU has to take care of academic part of the students studying in unaided institutions, while institutions have to take care of their own institutions, right from infrastructure, procurement of equipments, establishment of laboratories, and then academics, everything, even faculty development as well. And this project looks like this. There are 4 different quadrants coming together to help these focus states, green shaded area 1.1, focus states 1.1 and 1.2. Every institution is 1.1 and every university in a 1.2 in green shaded area is supported by mentors, partner institutions. These partner institutions are experienced institutions. Who is a partner institution of your? No, partner institution. Pardon? Maulana Azad University of Chhapra. Who is a partner institute?
Saharsa College of Engineering.
Where? Where from?
In Bihar.
No, no. Partner institute. Chhapra. Chhapra, you are very dear to me, near to me. Don't know. When you go back, ask who is a partner institute. All these partner institutes are experienced institutes who are autonomous, who have got their programs accredited. And basically, majority of these partner institutions are from south, below Gujarat, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and then all entire south. Some part of West Bengal and some part of Punjab and Haryana. Excepting these, rest are all focus states. I have a map, I will show that. So, each one of these university as well as institution under this green shaded area is supported by partner institutions. Partner institutions' performance will be counted based on your performance. So, it is made mandatory to these partner institutions that we will give you funding only when this institution improves, only when this institution gets accreditation, only when this faculty gets some training facilities. This is how the understanding is. We are taking constantly review of these arrangements which we call as a twinning arrangement. Recently, we had conducted one review. Again, in the month of April, May, we will be conducting the review on same ground. As to what has happened, we have noticed that nothing has happened in few cases. We have given them warning that if you don't do, next time you are out. So, 1.3 can be out any time, because their job is to help you, assist you, mentor you, partner with you. Take your students to their institution and show the laboratories and conduct the performance experiments, etc. Send your faculty to this institution and teach these students, because a particular subject, no teacher is available in the institute. So, all these things will be happening with this second quadrant. Third quadrant is IIT and IIMs. I have different slides, one slide each on IIT and IIM. But you have come here. IIT have accepted you only as a part of this third quadrant, because they are there in this third quadrant. There are 10 IITs who are a part of this KIT, KIT. You must have seen, read it on the Knowledge Incubation TechUp through IITs. There are 10 IITs and IIT, very prestigious, Kanpur is one of them. Also, there are 7 IIMs, Indian Institute of Management, where some management programs are going to happen for you, for the faculty, for you as well. Then fourth quadrant, because this is our important thing. We want to have accreditation, we want to have autonomy. Unless and otherwise we get this accreditation and autonomy, World Bank is not going to release. Remember, that is what the understanding between Ministry of External Affairs and World Bank is. Agreement is not signed by me, agreement is not signed by your principal. Agreement is signed by Department of External Affairs, DEA, with World Bank. World Bank will first of all assess, yes, how many such indicators have been achieved. If you have become accreditation, got accreditation, how many programs? Yes, so this much of money, this much. Okay, they have agreed, 1800 crores they will release, but based on achievement. Last time it never happened. Last time it was just releasing, whatever money now is coming to you, whatever money has come to IIT is from only Government of India share. It is only share from Government of India. No money so far has come from World Bank. So, therefore, World Bank will always be with us, will always be following us, following you as to what has happened to accreditation. And that is why this is a specific mention in your engagement offer that you have to achieve accreditation. We will provide all inputs because NBA is with us. Very shortly, 8th and 9th, there is a workshop at Delhi for TechUp coordinator, for NBA accreditation coordinator, NBA coordinator from your institute, and also TechUp coordinator. Two days workshop. The chairman of NBA himself will be coming and addressing these people. Can you imagine? The examiner is coming to address you. Examiner himself. And then not only this, because my faculty member, because this is important asset to the institution, to NPIU, to the World Bank. And without you, I know it is not going to happen. I am very sure, because I had been to Bombay, I had been to Indore, and I talked to people about accreditation. I inquired, yes, lot of curiosity, lot of anxiety, and lot of information they had. Go back to the institute and ask what is outcome based education, nobody will be able to answer properly. That is the situation. So, therefore, accreditation we are going to have, and for that purpose, unless and otherwise we make you aware about accreditation, it is not possible. And that is why very shortly in the month of March, 3-day workshops in your institute itself, we are going to deploy 30 experts. Every expert would be given 3 institutions, and such pair will come to your institute along with NPI person, maybe me or somebody else, and we will get it done. Don't worry, we are there because these 4 quadrants are there. AICT is also very much there. Whenever, wherever we conduct the programs, AICT representative, AICT expert is also there. Basically, we all are AICT people. You are also AICT person. So, this is how the synergistic approach is. So far, this is the statistics. There are 90 institutions for these focus states. There are 10 ATUs for the 1.2 component. And with these 90 institutions, we have mentor institutions, which I have mentioned 66. Out of 66, 19 are NITs. Some partner institutions are also NITs, very reputed NITs. And then there are also 2 IITs, IIT Guwahati and IIT Kharagpur, who have been mentoring some institutions. So, that is what I have mentioned here.
Sir, I have a quick question. If we have 30 IITs, why couldn't they be the partners rather than
No, problem is IITs have so many things to do. They have their own PG, UG, PhD programs. They have their own consultancy, this and that programs, and because of which they are not able to send their faculty members to your institutions. In fact, it's not a one way that you only going to there, because unless they see your institution, they won't be able to prescribe you properly, or without seeing patient, giving prescription is very dangerous. So that fear we had, and that's why we said let us restrict to two IITs only, not that all IITs. Otherwise, they would have been very happy. Now also they are happy. They, you know, you have seen professor how he was, you know, telling you, yes, you are most welcome. I will check some faculties available or not in my institution, something like that. So his availability itself is a problem, no? Right? If suppose a faculty member from IIT is outside the institution, lot of academic loss to their own students will happen, and then quality of our IIT in the process of improving quality of other institutions will go down. Right? Okay. So you know they cannot spend a huge amount of time with the institution. What we expect that this mentor institution, they have some two faculty members, say signals and system in electronics, and say for example what is that internet of things in computers, these are very difficult subject, or electromagnetics in electrical. So the two faculty member will come to your institution, spend their 15 days, teach, and so this is our country, little bit distorted, not intentionally, because of space, right? So you can see red spots, all red spots are here, red triangle is your institute, red circle are ATUs, sorry, not circle, squares, these are all ATUs. And all black or blue triangles here, they are all your partner institutions. So you can see majority partner institutions are located here. Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Andhra, one institution, two institutions in Gujarat, some institution is in Punjab also, some institution here also in West Bengal. Okay? Right? So this is a spread. We publish this quarterly newsletter. Now, next quarterly newsletter is likely to come here in the coming week, within a week. And there your all photographs, I don't know how many photographs have been sent here from here. So, your photographs you will also find in this quarterly newsletter. Just wanted to tell you about newsletter. But it is very clear, you know, when I joined, I have prepared this vision document. You also prepare a vision document for your institute or at least for yourself. Vision document should have what are my strengths, what are my weaknesses. Vision document should have short term goals, long term goals. So, strategies to achieve these goals. So, this vision document is available on our website. Website is npiu.nic.in.
So you just check npiu.nic, all circulars, because there was a complaint from you people that sir, circulars do not reach to us, they go to, you know, NPI cannot send circular to each and every faculty member of the institute. The circulars are always available on NPI website. So this is how I think one has to start his career, one has to start progress of his institution. Oh, sorry. Now, I think there are 2-3 slides, they are blank. Earlier also, I faced same problem. These blank slides are, actually they are very important, but I don't have hard copies also. Blank slides are related to the number of students who are studying in different states, in engineering colleges, your colleges. Number of institutions and how many students are studying. So, I don't know, I will try to ensure that this particular presentation is made available to you, and you can also just go through that and just try to draw inferences based on the population. But my dear friends, please remember, that from these focus states we have something like 1.3 lakh students taking benefit of this project, 1.3 lakhs, 1.86 lakhs from 1.3 institutions. That means the number of institutions in non-focus states, they are less, 66, and from 66, 1.86 students are taking education. From these focus states, there are 90 institutions and only 1.3 lakh students are taking education. That means these states are really focused states, really wanted some attention, and that is what has happened. So is the case with your ATUs. There are 10 ATUs in focused states. The total student strength in 10 ATUs is 3.5 lakhs. 10 ATUs focused states, 3.5 lakhs, and there are only 3 institutions, 3 ATUs in non-focused states, the total student population is 5.6 lakhs. So, total taken together 5.6, 3.5, 1.86 and 1.3, this is the total students, you know, total students who are going to be beneficiary in the project. Now, what are the expectations? When does World Bank release money? How it can release? That is shown here. And what we are supposed to do, what for we are engaged, and what we are going to learn from the project is, that is shown here. First four we call as DLI, disbursement link indicators. Four DLIs, first four. 1, 2, 3, 4. What is first? First is increase in NBA accredited UG and PG programs. The target for 3 years is 60%. That means in your institute, suppose there are 10 programs, UG, PG taken together. By the end of the project, at least 6 programs should get accreditation. 587 programs are there. 587 programs in all these 90 institutions. Out of 587, 60%, you can calculate something like 370 programs should get accredited. Today it is only 25. There are institutions who have got some programs accredited, but it is only 25. That means in this particular time span, we have to get accreditation of at least 350 programs. This is a great target for all of us. We have contacted NBA. We are trying to get some benefits to these institutions, consider these institutions, forfeit some criteria. We said, don't compromise with the quality. Quality is going to be there. We will try to maintain quality. Now, what is accreditation? Accreditation consists of 9 criteria. Are you aware about anybody? Very good. Yes. There are some criteria, 9 criteria. First, second, third, fourth, something like that. Some sections are there. And what is that? It is not output based. It is outcome based. It is not output based. It is outcome based education. Now, what is the difference between output and outcome? Output means how many students pass, how many students appeared. Pass divided by appeared is output. That is what we say percentage result. Okay. It is 12. I don't know.
Just few more minutes and then we will just bring them back after the lab, back here.
Okay. Should I finish this and then
you
go?
Can finish, yes.
Yeah. Okay. After this, we will be going to lab. That is also important. So, pass divided by appeared is a percentage. It is called as output.
We don't want output, we want outcome. Outcome means what? What a particular engineering graduate should achieve, what attributes he should achieve. There are 10 attributes which are called as graduate attributes. You refer any document, it is available. You may be aware about Washington Accord, you may be aware about Abbott criteria, right. So, there are some program outcomes PO, and those program outcomes are nothing but graduate attributes. Discipline wise they will change, but spirit wise they remain same. And what is that? That what it says is a collaboration, teamwork. You have to evaluate this candidate on the basis of teamwork. Can your electrical machine evaluate him? Can your physics evaluate him on the basis of? It can, but we never do that. How suppose in a chemistry he is to be evaluated on for teamwork? How can you evaluate him in chemistry for graduate attribute teamwork? Can somebody answer? Simple, four students together performing some experiment. You are a teacher, evaluator, you stand out long distance and just observe who is helping whom. How is the team? Who is a odd man out? Simple, but we never do that. And that is where our education system is failing. What do? We give him 6 questions, some options, give him answer book. Sometimes Chhapra cheating. yes, it is true. His director of technical education himself told me about a week ago. Where is the teamwork? Yeah, teamwork is there. Environmental friendliness is another graduate attribute. You just check. Environmental friendliness. Where do we do this? Again, same physics paper. Where is environmental friendliness? We are in hurry, such a hurry that student, start. Do. Write some journal. Show me. Get out. That's all. We don't spend time with the students to evaluate how environmental friendly he is. In every subject, all these 10 graduate attributes can be evaluated. We never thought of. Abbott has given us. And now people are not listening because again we are again in a hurry always. If it is anything less than 60%, we are very much disturbed. Right from father, mother, grandfather, grandmother to your younger sister and brother. Everybody is disturbed. If suppose you don't get first class in your engineering degree, that is the issue. And that's why this accreditation, my dear friends, you are our hopes. We are there. We will just discuss little later about your future, etcetera. But then provided you get us something, and that is what accreditation. Now again, there are disturbing forces in your institution. Remember, many people, all old stalwarts, so-called experts, they would try to distract you, disturb you and deviate you from your object. Arre, accreditation chhod do yaar, kuch bhi bakbak karne, hame bhi kaam mein laga doge kya? So this is going to happen. And what is, during the process, what do you get is you become expert. Please remember, you become expert and you would be most favorite people. Today the consultants for accreditation are earning like anything. I don't know, and you also don't know where your career would be, where your future would be, where you would be. I have never thought of And I am a person who belongs to a small village of 60 population. Can you imagine 60 population? Today also I go there. 60 population where my mother tongue was also not pure. I became principal without, you know, I never thought of flying. See the situation. So we don't know. Don't look at to the negative things, just see the positive things. Do and see and ensure that something happens in your career. Something you do which is very useful to the society. Society, you know, if society gets happier, you are happier. So this is very clear statistics, and first DLI is accreditation. Second DLI is autonomy. Let us wait, first of all get accreditation first, because for autonomy, for applying for autonomy, you require to have accreditation. At least 50% program should be accredited, then only your application for autonomy is accepted by UGC. This is second. And third and fourth DLIs are related to GET, and that is the reason why we demanded GET. There are 19 court cases in High Court, 19 against. Why you have asked for GET? If suppose 1300 post, we got 14,000 applications with GET. Out of 1300, we selected 27 such a candidate who did their B.Tech from IIT. Out of 1300, 297 candidates have done PhD, and out of 297, 266 candidates have done PhD from. This is the beauty. Let these litigations and complaints and let that happen, no problem. Why I am very clear, MHRD is very clear, Government of India is very, World Bank is also very clear. Why we have insisted for GET? Because my two DLIs are related to GET, and unless and otherwise I give proper training to the students and get them GET qualified, my institutions won't get money. So simple it is. World Bank won't give 1800 crores, and then project will stop somewhere in between. We don't want to see that it stops. What is the GET? GET, what is the present scoring rate, qualifying rate? Are you aware? 20? 17%. 16 to 17% last 4 years, not this year. Last 4 years, the GET qualification percentage is 16 to 17. And what is the target for us? You know? 25%. Beyond imagination. Okay, is it possible? Yes, no, everything is possible. Why not? Everything is possible. If you are with me, everything is possible. I will tell you how are we going to support the system. Don't worry, we will get qualification improved in our institutions only, no problem. 28,000 students from our institution this year applied for GET examination. 28,000. Every one of them will not qualify, we know. Even maybe 10%, 20%, but certainly next year it will improve. Even if today it is 16%, 17%, we are at par. Who said we are focused? We are non-focused. Who said we are having poor quality? We are at par quality. All those NIT candidates 16-17%, we are also 16-17%. What is wrong? So at least let us start from here. Let us go back to your institution and just check how many students qualified. You may not be having that data, you know, your institutions, those stalwarts, they didn't bother to collect the data, how many students appeared and how many students. This is the situation, my dear. And that is the reason, my dear friends, please remember these four DLIs. Always think about four DLIs. My mail ID is available with you. If it is not, it is available on website, and send me some suggestions as to how to achieve these DLIs. I am always free. Okay? So, we stop here, but there are, my dear friends, many slides. I do not know how can we finish. Let us hope that I also address at least 4 or 5 queries from your side. Try to be prepared with very good and important and genuine queries, 4 or 5 queries, so that vital few we can address, right. I am repeatedly telling you, the giving you the importance of these DLIs. Because we are bound to achieve all this, but suppose in case we fail somewhere, naturally our funding will reduce, or maybe that, you know, adverse, most adverse is, you know, will not be able to proceed, and therefore we have to focus on this. I told you autonomy is a long process. The institute, first of all, has to acquire this accreditation at least in 50% programs, then only you are able to apply for autonomy. When it comes to autonomy, your university, affiliating university, it also plays its important role. The university has got its own statute, and statute comes by the act of assembly. So, somewhere we have seen, for example, Kerala. Not a single institute today from Kerala is part of TechU. Kerala was there in TechU 1, it was there in TechU 2 as well, but it is not a part of TechU 3. The reason is, no institute is autonomous. The institutions are accredited, they got accreditation, somewhere 60% programs, 70% programs. Sorry. But because the state government does not have created some act for universities to grant autonomy, their application could not be forwarded to UGC. That is a problem. So, there are many more factors responsible for getting autonomy. We are discussing with the respective state governments, so that all these acts are ready by the time institute reaches to that particular status, at least they are eligible to apply for accreditation, autonomy. But before that, accreditation is very must. The other issue which we have already discussed is GATE. GATE has got 2 DLIs. We know it is very uphill task to reach to 25 when the country's rate is 16%, 17%. But then we are focused, we are restricted to a particular institution, and there we would like to have 25% qualified, GATE qualified students. In addition to this, there are about 22 key performance indicators. See, all these things are available in the document, and document is available on website. The name of the document is Project Implementation Plan, PIP. This Project Implementation Plan contains so many academic initiatives, and few of those academic initiatives, they have been enlisted here from maybe bullet number 5 to say 10. We will be discussing these academic issues one by one in the next slides. But then a last point is project support through teachers enhancement fund for hiring contract faculty at entry level. This is also envisaged, that is also mentioned in the document, that your salary is being paid through teachers enhancement fund. Teacher enhancement fund, there is no limitation as such. whatever institutions, whatever number of faculty, assistant professor, entry level faculty, institutions need for accreditation, that will be provided. There is no limitation that, you know, only 100 crore, 200 crore or 300 crore. Even the our package, what you say, remuneration, honorarium, whatever you call as salary, that also has been evolved after so many iterations. First of all, it has started with 45,000, then 50,000, then 55,000, 60,000. Then lot of calculations we have done. Now 7th pay commission is coming, then faculty members, you know, the present faculty member, a fresh assistant professor, regular faculty member should not receive, should not get more than what we will be giving to this contract faculty. That was my presentation, that was my viewpoint, and based on that this is evolved. Let me tell you, we are also thinking to give you an increment. It is in just thinking stage, it has not come on paper, but maybe some percentage of your honorarium will be paid as an increment after 1 year, provided it is mentioned, provided we reach to a particular level of satisfaction, your performance appraisal is of that particular level. So for this, what we have done, that we have enhanced qualification, we have already discussed, and you also know that. We mentioned preference will be given to the candidates who have done their UG, PG or PhD from Indian National Ionized Institute of National Importance. There is no question, there is no debate, there is no, it is not a point for debate that which institute is INI, which is not. All the list of the, you know, institutions who are, who fall under INI, who have been categorized as INI, that is available on MHRD website as well. So there is no question, because few people started arguing with us that, sir, why this institute, X institute, is not INI, because, you know, it has got accreditation, it is autonomous, it is deemed university, this and that. We said no. INI definition is not evolved by me. INI definition is evolved by some other agency, some other statutory authority, and they have not regarded X institute as INI. So that is why we cannot treat. So whatever the list that contains, based on that preference was given. Your payment, I heard, you have not received, few of you or maybe all of you, you have not received. Normally payment date is 1st of every month. Your cycle is also very clear, 25th to 24th, 25th of last month to 24th of this month, and payment is expected to reach to you on 1st, but your payment is direct through virtual virtual transfer of money to your account. That means we are giving money funds to the institution, not in their account. They do not get in their account. That comes through public finance management system, PFMS they call it as. Many of the institutions are not aware about. We have trained, we have conducted about 3 to 4 workshops. We will also conduct one workshop for you as to how to operate PFMS. Very, very, you know, typical, complicated, but once you, you know, it is the online portal, and it is the online portal of Government of India. Earlier what is to happen, I tell you, that the money was going to the institution's account, not directly from NPIU, but NPIU to state government and state government to, then what was happening, that the institutions were feeling shortage of funds at times, because there are processes. Money won't come directly, file cannot be signed in a day, never, because it is a process, it has to go through process. So that means for next month salary, suppose it was like that, then next month salary, for that you had to start about 6 months before, then only it was possible. So now all these complications, issues have been resolved. Now money is directly coming to the institution, but not in its account. It comes virtually in their account. Moment they
apply digital signature, then that money you are registered there as a vendor, and when you register your name is registered as a vendor, in that case your account details, IFC code, this and that, everything is now provided. Only the principal has to apply his digital signature and then it goes there. Now suppose this is happening like this, and if it happens after 4 p.m. Pardon?
Because there is staff deficiency in the college, why not send the money directly to our college?
It is directly, my dear friend. I tell you, just that's why I said, if suppose money is paid after 4 p.m., what happens in RTGS, you know. If you are doing RTGS after 4 p.m., money goes to the account
next day.
If it happens early in the morning, money goes to your account same day. So it is a 24-hour maximum period it takes, right? Now, many places what happens, the people are not habituated of. There are two options. In one institution, suppose there is one institution, BITS Misra, where 82 faculty members are, they have joined, 82. Now, 82 transactions, 82 times digital signature is a complicated issue, it takes lot of time. Second, it's online portal. Online portal, you know what happens online portal. Third, the bandwidth at the institute level. Fourth, if it is J&K and say for example Uttarakhand or maybe Northeast, again the fourth problem is also there, that the service providers are less. So that's why sometimes it is failure. So therefore, we have given another option, that it is a bulk posting. You prepare a list of, you know, the payees, the vendors or the faculty, and maybe suppose 80 faculty members, 80, how much money you provide this, what you say, import that list into the PFMS, immediately transaction will happen. But and in that case only once you have to use a digital signature, that is the issue. So that also has been told and informed, but then could be that there are some institutions where still they have lot of fear in using the digital signature. It's a digital signature means you may be aware, DSC, it's just like your pen drive. Now it is normally in possession with the principal, so principal may also have got fear. I have my own digital signature, that DSC I never written with me, it is always with my accountant and he is using like that. So this happens only when you don't have any kind of fear, but then there could be few principals where I think this kind of fear is there, and because of which he is not giving that digital signature to his accountant. So because the system is new, because this is first time it is happening, maybe that this time it will take little more time. But still, yesterday I think at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I have checked how much money has gone to the account of faculty. We expected 4.5 crore, yesterday 3 p.m., yesterday means it is a 31st, it is not first, first is today. Yesterday 3 p.m., it was 1.36 crore, it was already given, I mean paid to the faculty member. So somewhere it is happening, somewhere it is not happening, this is the situation. We will try to find out, let us experience difficulty one more month, and then maybe that we find out some corrective action. Now we come to this again, same, how many positions, how many applications we got, you can see here 13,437 applications, I mean all eligible, but we have not interviewed all. Again there was a objection from few of the candidates, that why you have accepted our application but you are not interviewing, because you know we did not want to interview each and every, because you know you can see 1300 and 13000 means 1:10. So interviewing 10 candidates as against one post is not at all advisable. So therefore we made a provision in our advertisement itself, that shortlisting will be done in case the number of applicants are more,
disproportionate to the number of posts. So, based on that, we have interviewed about 7206, and then during this process you have joined. Then some part from your engagement offers, engagement letters, that is what I have simply produced here. But before that, we did not keep any reservation. So, simple it is that it is not recruitment, it is an engagement. Reservation is there for the full time post, reservation is there for the permanent post, reservation is there for the sanctioned post. Your appointments are not against the sanctioned post, because institution wanted certain number of faculty. That is why we have identified those many number from each of the institutions, and accordingly we have given allocation. And when it is not recruitment, reservation is not applicable. Secondly, reservation varies from state to state. Reservation depends on roster of the institution. We do not know how many seats are sanctioned there, how many, you know, posts are sanctioned. We do not know what kind of reservation every individual institution, every individual state has. And therefore, reservation, considering reservation, basically it is not required, but even we consider it sympathetically, it was not possible, and that is why there was no reservation. Second, which one, you know, this is a question raised by you as to what will happen to us after 3 years. That for that, this is a second point. Second point is, we are working with the management of the institutions. The institutions are not owned by the government of India. Institutions are owned by state government. They are state government or government aided. That means they are owned by the state government. So therefore, we cannot appoint, and state government cannot accept directly. But still we are working with the management. So far, two states, I will not name the states, two states have come forward saying that, yes sir, those who are good, well performing, we will continue. Continue means on a regular post. But I will not name the states. But still, we are discussing with other states as well. Every now and then, every quarterly, we have a review meeting of principal secretary, if you are aware about. Principal secretary of respective states. All these 19 secretaries, they come to Delhi and we sit for a meeting. There is an agenda. One of the agenda is always going to be this second point. So, this is the second point. Let us wait. Let us wait. We are trying, and I do not know whether we get 100% success, or maybe 50%, or maybe 25%. But then there would be some success. Some states would agree. They have already agreed. They said, yes, we will go ahead. But then let us see. Let us wait for their performance. So, now we have to be very particular about performance. Yes? What about? No question? Okay. Third point is cover. As of now, your positions are coterminous with the project. Till then, we have to be ready. We have to accept the reality. We cannot run away from the reality, because tomorrow, suppose some state is ready to accept you, but then only well performing, we do not know whether we will be well performing in there from their point of view or not. So, that also is very subjective. So, therefore, as of now, we have to be very ready that these are the coterminous, these engagements are coterminous with the project. Then project funding. So, simple it is, as of now, not a single rupee is paid by your institution by state government. Remember, it is paid through the project, and project belongs to the World Bank. So, World Bank is there for 3 years with us. After 3 years, World Bank won't be there, and naturally there won't be any funding. That's why we normally say that it's the funding, and it is till September 2020, because as of now, on paper, this is a debt, September 2020. We expect that it will get extended by maybe somewhere like 6 months, 9 months. So, that session would be over. Then seventh point is very important, and repeatedly I am telling that whatever funding is happening through World Bank, I said 50% share, it is all linked with these deliverables. So, DLIs are to be achieved, and therefore, each one of us should be committed to achieve these DLIs. Whatever extent it is possible, somebody says accreditation should be 60%, okay. In our institution, situation is something like say 50%, no problem. Somewhere 50%, somewhere naturally is going to be 90%, so that gets accommodated. But then every one of us, every one of the institution, we have been sensitizing your principal as well. That's why you must have seen that in few institutions, their regular faculty are not working for accreditation. They say, sir, we don't know. And that's why entire burden comes to you. Doesn't matter, because you know whatever assignments are given may be overburden. It is an opportunity for gaining experience. Remember, my dear friends, please try to understand, it is an opportunity for gaining the experience. And this experience, whatever you achieve for accreditation, maybe for autonomy, maybe for the next points, which very important point I am going to tell you, these are going to help you on a long run. Please remember, you all are young, almost young, right? So at least younger than me. So this is going to help you. I never in throughout my career never said no to any assignment, though I am very, very busy. That's why I told somebody that I work right from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. No time I leave my office before 9 p.m. No time. And this is a story for last about 20-25 years. Not that today I have become central project advisor and just, you know, trying to impress you all and impress my authority. Nothing. No impressing, nothing. Nobody is going to install my statue in any of the office. I know that. Everything is known. Everything. Even Mahatma Gandhi is also blamed today, right? Everybody for that matter is blamed today. So that is not the thing. Thing is that the passion. When we want to develop our career, naturally we have to be passionate about the career. And career means what? Doing something for the students, for the education. That is what my point is. Then I think that is all. Then mandatory gate condition. Why mandatory? Because 2 out of 4 DLIs are gate. Very simple. Tell your friends, those friends who were not, you know, having gate score and maybe complaining, still complaining. Right to Information Act, somewhere about 600 complaints. Please try to understand. My 3 people, including myself, we always are busy in replying Right to Information Act. You are aware about RTI, yes. Right? And it is very serious otherwise, right? Well, it doesn't matter. I take it very positively. Yes, somebody is aggrieved, is having some grievance. It has to be addressed. It has to be replied. I am reply answerable. I am accountable. So naturally, I have to reply. Very simple. So many principals, your principals, they take it RTI, you know, like anything, you know, some big thing which has come on them, and then they are in trouble as if they have done something wrong. When you have not done anything wrong, let us not bother about that. So DLIs, then GATE, then shortlisting criteria. I think I have made it amply clear. Tell your friends, those still are having some grievances, still containing their complaints, submitting complaints. Even some ministers, they approach some honorable member of parliament, they approach. It doesn't matter, because we are very clear that why shortlisting is done, why somebody is not called for interview, why GATE only is considered, so on and so forth. Because I am going to be paid by World Bank, and World Bank said unless you have GATE, we will not pay. And naturally, we did not have any other option but to go for GATE. So therefore, we have not compromised with AICT qualification at all. Our stand is very clear that we have not compromised. We have little bit gone ahead. We have raised our educational qualification, and that too only for GATE. And GATE, so simple justification for GATE is. Then shortlisting criteria, and then there are few faculty. In fact, Bihar and these J&K, these are very good states at least. But majority complaints are from Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh, MP. Because Rajasthan has got some faculty member working there who are visiting faculty or contract faculty and who are paid 24,000 or 21,000. Now he is appointed and he is getting 70,000, point number one. And now I am feeling myself unnecessarily inferiority complex, and thinking that and having a fear that now I will be thrown out of the system, I will be terminated. And on this pretext, they approach court. My point here is grievance of already working faculty on ad hoc or contract or visiting basis, they think that they have a fear they think that we will be out. In fact, your appointment, your engagement is not for making anybody out of the system. Very simple. Perform or perish. We are very clear. In fact, I am nobody. I am nobody to throw anybody out of their institution, because it's the institution who has to decide. Right? If suppose institution thinks that this fellow is not useful, somebody else would be better, naturally he will throw it out. So simple it is. So this is what the grievance is, but people cannot make mess of it. Now we come to the activities. You can see there are three compartments here. First compartment is for students. First compartment is for students, improving students' learning. It's very nice that IIT Kanpur has arranged your visits to the different laboratories. The learning starts from laboratory, very simple. Unfortunately, we are taking it other way. Unfortunately, we take it other way that no, classroom teaching is very important. Why this is the conception? So simple, because passing theory examination is difficult and practicals are easy, very easy. No student fail in practical examination, right? But then for theory examination is, and that's why everybody is giving more importance to the classroom teaching. So that's very good. That at least, you know, in engineering at least, the learning starts from laboratory. In science, learning starts from laboratory, not from classroom. Classroom, we have to find out different applications of a particular concept, but then concepts are learned in laboratory. So please go back to your institution. Convince your principal. Convince your principal that sir, such and such laboratory is very essential. We have seen in IIT Kanpur, the laboratory was so excellent, the students were so enthusiastic. You know, I used to conduct, you know, the programs for this when I was a director. That time I was addressing one, this group of students, somewhere about more than 1200 candidate students were sitting, and all this students studying in engineering colleges. I asked them one question. I had given three options and asked them to rate. One, first option was classroom teaching. Second option was laboratory teaching, laboratory learning. Third option was project doing. Have you understood? Three options. I said which one you would rate high. What is second and what is the third option? Right? Everybody said, sir, we like project. Second option was? And third and most boring option was? See the thing. So we should understand the psychology of the students. Students want to learn. We normally blame students that they don't want to learn. They want to learn, but they don't want to learn in a restricted place. That is the point. So that's why I'm just stressing the need for your laboratory things and whatever visits are taking place. Similarly, research assistantship, peer learning, bridge course, then appointing faculty advisors, increasing this and that. Second quadrant is for you. These are all options available for you for growing, for progressing your career, for building your career, for achieving the different targets and improving, increasing our CV. Try to focus on this. In these 3 years, at least you decide. That's why I was just insisting on you preparing your own vision document for your career. What I am supposed to do in this year? How many papers to be published? How many students to be guided? How many projects to be guided? How many patents? See, patent is not a difficult thing. A 7th class girl can file patent, 7th standard. 7th standard girl can file patent. We all are BTech, MTech, PhD, get qualified. Why not? This project will help you to get facilitation from the legal advisors for patenting. What is patenting? What can be patented? What cannot be patented? If at all some idea is there and yes, it is through, then what is the procedure? Whatever facilitation fee is required, yes, fee will can be reimbursed through the project. So the project is very important. You should feel honored that you are a part of this project. Remember, lot many things you can gain through this project, and all those things are kept in the second quadrant, second part. So increasing faculty productivity, motivation, faculty training, pedagogy training, Management capacity development, MCD, which will happen in IIMs, student feedback, peer review, refresher courses with certification every year, then improving teachers' effectiveness, you can attend conferences, and then also qualification up. Qualification upgradation is not that, you know, registration for DSC, going abroad, this and that. Qualification upgradation means you can have some kind of setup mechanism with IIT, because we are also discussing with all these 10 IITs how best the staggered period for clearing their course, your courses you have to clear before registering for PhD, right. So, how best that period can be staggered so that you can attend those classes, those courses when no academics is happening in your institution. Because your appointment basically is for the student, not for yourself. We should remember this thing. That means my absence from the institution should not suffer, because yesterday, day before yesterday, in different programs, people were asking, sir, I want to go to my native place, so can I take leave? No, see, sir, you know, my sister's delivery is there, so I have to be there for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, or one month. One lady has come with that maternal, what is that, delivery leave. One father has come for a paternal leave, 1 month or 2 months or 3 months. See, basically our engagement is for the students. If that is not, served, then I think, I don't have any say to that. So, therefore, what I said, that you can do all these things provided your student's academic does not get hampered. That is what the precaution you have to take. And then third part is some other thing. Now, what more we can do for the students, for the self? This is coming under AICT mandate. There are about 10 points. Out of 10 points, 7 points I am going to explain one by one. First one is, and just try to see which particular mandate appeals you most. Try to identify here only today. You just try to identify which particular mandate appeals you more, and then try to do that. Try to apply that in your institution. Take up. Because this is what, you know, it is a part of our TechU project. So, take up that particular thing, go to your principal and say that, sir, I will take care of this. Maybe two, three of you from same institute come together, form a group and tell your principal that, sir, we would like to go for induction program. Now, what is induction program? Are you aware? No. Right? Induction program, you have also gone through induction program. When you take admission to first year BTech, what happens on first day?
Introduction to the department.
Yes, visits to the department. Second?
Visit to the labs.
Visit to the lab. Third?
Introducing the all faculty members.
Speeches of faculty member. You know, there is a program for about 3 hours. Right? 3 hours, principal and all heads of department, all dignitaries are here. Entire 300, 400 students are sitting here in the audience, right? Program starts, never starts right time. 10, 15 minutes, half an hour, sometimes 1 hour also. You are sitting there without water, right? Your parents are also sitting, right? Then somebody stands up and says, yes, welcome you all. Then I invite head of the department civil. He stands up, tells something about 15 minutes, somebody takes half an hour also. About civil department, boys are unaware, because I am from computers. Why should I listen to civil engineering? Is it not? Then mechanical stands, again same thing happens. Sometime somebody completes in 5 minutes, somebody takes about 1 hour. Then electrical, electronics, computer, all heads. Then who? Training placement officer. Then librarian also sometimes. Sometimes your registrar. This program goes for 3 hours, 3 long hours, without tea, without water, and nothing. Everybody is sitting. After that, what happens? No lunch break.
They will send to respective.
No lunch break. Entire 300 students are divided into 5 batches. Every one faculty is assigned to every batch. Yes, faculty X will take civil, Y, mechanical, something like that. Goes entire round, post office, ATM, library, office, all laboratories, workshop, playground, hostel, till what time? 5, 6 o'clock.
no tea, no water, and nothing, and no break. What happens to the student? End of the day, completely exhausted. Feel like not going to the college next day. Simple? It's of no use. That what we call it as an induction program. No, induction program is never like that. On the contrary, what is happening? Students from remote areas are coming to the college. They are not aware about engineering. Till yesterday, they were attending coaching tuition classes. Right from morning till evening. Communication may be mother tongue, even in class. Never seen such a huge laboratories wherever they are, right? Never seen. Everybody comes to the class, next day first lecture, mathematics teacher comes. What does he write on the blackboard? Doesn't know. I mean, students do not know. Speaks in English. See the problem. Hostel is given, all three roommates are different people, places, not known to each other. One is from X district, other one Y, and third one is Z. X is from one religion, Y is from another religion, Z is from third religion. Sometimes different language, not able to understand, just see each other but cannot speak because languages are different. See, this is the situation. And the boy doesn't spend even a month or two, there is examination. Library books are not issued. Where from he can understand, he can learn from the, you know, this subject. Classroom teaching is not understood. See, this is a situation. There are about 20-30% students who doesn't know what is happening in the institution. Either such students leave after 1 year, the entire engineering, no, engineering is beyond my scope. Or fails miserably so many times. This should not happen. So many suicides were happening in IITs, you have understood, you have learned, and also ragging is another issue. See, different religions, different things, different places, different language, and basically I have got my own problems, my financial problem is, position is not good. So all these issues are there, and therefore, you know, your education doesn't become encouraging. For that purpose, solution is this. This is made mandatory now from next academic year in our institutions, all tech keep institutions. We made it mandatory from this semester only. In your institution, it must have been done. Maybe few people have done for 3 days, few people have done for 5 days, few people have gone for 2 weeks also. That is what induction program it is called as. Right? If you like this, take this matter. Because students are our assets, remember. And students carry our reputation with them. You have to mix up with the students. You have to help the students. What it says that behind every 20 students, we need to have one faculty mentor. And this program will happen for 3 weeks. What will happen in 3 weeks? 3 weeks, these things will happen. Universal human values. Many points, I will not touch this because curriculum is available on NPIU website as well. Physical activities, people have forgotten last 2 years, you know, lot of tuitions and this and that. No physical exercise. So, physical activities, then arts and craft training, then guest lectures, local visits, not only this. We blame that our students are poor in physics. We blame that our students are poor in mathematics. And when physics and mathematics are poor, engineering gone. And whom we blame? We blame their teachers at 11th and 12th. How long we blame? Till final year. See, this is the situation. So, instead of blaming others, let us start ourselves. So, therefore, in these 3 weeks, we have a finishing courses on physics, mathematics and computational skills. Please do not blame me, chemistry people. Chemistry is also there. Right? So, we have prepared a syllabus, 20-hour syllabus for physics, 20-hour syllabus for mathematics. See, it's not necessary that mathematics should be taught by only mathematics teacher. I am mechanical, I can also teach. I can take better applications from my mechanical engineering and teach them
If I am teaching them partial differentiation, I will not teach like the our mathematics friends do. We will be doing it a different way. So this is happening. That means with in first 3 weeks, students are ready with conceptual knowledge. Students are ready with his, you know, he has already identified his area of interest other than academics. Whether I am interested in physical activities, sports, I am interested in culture, art, what? So he has already identified that. Students in this way, human value is very important and interesting part. All IITs they have started. IIT Kanpur also started this year. IIT Gandhinagar 7 years ago they have started human values. IIT BHU have got 150 faculty members trained for training human values. 150. Can you understand? We will conduct training session for you also. All these 1300 faculty members in a group of 50 human values sessions will be conducted for 3 days. Sometime. Let us wait, because next year you have to wait for. The moment your first year batch comes, that time you have to get yourself involved into this. This is not going to only help the students, your students, but it will help you to improve your own life, remember. So such a important and powerful tool this human value is. People nowadays have forgotten. We don't know, we don't understand what do we mean by competition. We don't know, understand what do we mean by relationship. Everything has gone. Even today, mother, father, wife, mother and son, relationship is, you know, it's not that what we expected and we had in our culture. So that is what this human value is. So this is the first area. Second area, this very important, startups. You are interested? Yes, take it up. If you are interested in research, take it up. If you are interested in patenting and doing some research activities, yes, do it. But don't do it alone. You take a group of students. With that group, what you can do, you know, immediately, maybe within a month or so, you just try to mobilize the student. You should get support of students, remember. You have to impress students what is the importance of this. And students, we know, and I know, that they like this startup and this kind of activities very much. What is that? See here, competitions. You can start these competitions, idea stage. There are n number of problems in the institutions. Let them identify what are the problems and let them give solutions. Cost effective solution, costless solution, very innovative solutions. Such competitions you can start, and you can start awarding prizes through the project. Whatever money is required for doing these activities, that is admissible through the project, right? So this is second area. Third area is, startup is over. Third area is, it is made mandatory now. I think J&K, somebody's foods technology, they were just discussing during that tea time, and I was just listening to them. It's very wonderful thing. People have forgotten. The students do not see the industry, engineering student, do not see the industry till he completes his degree, he gets degree. I know the students who have never seen lathe machine but got BE mechanical. I know many students, not seen lathe. I am not talking about visiting industry, not seen lathe machine, because institution doesn't have lathe machine. It's a continuous process, it's an automatic process. Once you get in, you are out after 4 years. By hook or chapra. No, I'm not criticizing, but that is a situation. We want to overcome that. That is very important. Otherwise, this will happen. So therefore, doctors, what do they have? They have internship. You know, internship degree is not given, you don't get registration certificate unless. Therefore, in engineering it was missing, now it is made mandatory. Well, I have been telling your principals, your faculty members, that start internship this year only. I have asked them to prepare a list of industries, MSMEs. I have sent them a list of industries. many people are coming, board of apprenticeship coming, AICT has done what is that, MOU with intern Shala, who is ready to give 1.25 lakhs students training in the industry, different industry. Board of apprenticeship training, you may be aware that apprenticeship act is there, all industries are controlled by board and every industry has to accept 5, 7, 10 students for this apprenticeship. So under that also students can be absorbed, and then this is internship. What is this? This is throughout degree, 3 times internship, minimum 4 weeks, maximum 6 weeks, 3 times, how many times? That means after first year, after second year and after third year, final year after he goes out. So every after, you know, every year. Now questions came from principal, our stalwarts, that you know student has just studied physics, mathematics, engineering graphics, engineering mechanics, electrical engineering, computer programming, workshop. How can he go to the industry and how can he understand? Let him see. Forget understanding. Let him see the processes, how the lathe looks like. Today he, let him see the lathe, and tomorrow you teach in the classroom on the blackboard, draw lathe. He will say, sir, don't draw lathe, we have seen. He will send you WhatsApp. This is the lathe machine, sir. It has lathe, what is it? Head stock, dead stock, this stock, that stock, right? So this is how AICT says, and it is made mandatory throughout country, it is happening. On 24th, we had workshop where 196 university vice chancellors were there. 196 university vice chancellors throughout the country. 196, those universities where engineering colleges are affiliated. Our ATUs were also there. We also called them. And today only I have just now sent message asking our ATUs, all 10 ATUs from focus states, to submit their action plan before the end of February. As to how internship they are going to incorporate into their curriculum. We will do. But gradually, you know, everything, you know, working on all fronts at a time is beyond anybody's scope. It's not possible. You said, you go on telling me, sir, I have not got my, what is that, salary. Even on 5th of the, you know, February, you will also say same. Sir, still, 5 days ho gaye abhi tak, salary nahi aaya. So, you know, we have to work on so many fronts simultaneously. We are trying our level best, trying to pursue the people, because principal got his salary, he is not bothered about, and he has gone on leave and carrying his digital signature. So simple it is, it's a fact, it's a practical thing we have to think about. Then what can I do? Can I terminate principal? No, because he is not my employee. Then what should I do? I will talk to principal secretary. Now principal secretary is also holding 4 charges. He is looking after education, he is looking after irrigation, he is looking after rehabilitation, and he is also looking after finance. Budget is happening. So he is very busy. He doesn't have time to pick up the phone call. So this is the situation. So fact point, point of view, we have to think everything and then go ahead. So internship, if it is your area, please take up this. Next is industry readiness. Now this is related to your placement. Somebody says there is no placement. Placement doesn't happen in a day. I think I told my story. The institute one placement was 17%. 17%. Story is 2004-5. Placement was 17%. So what did I do? I started shouting others. I started blaming my students. No. I started preparing my students. I started mobilizing the support of my faculty. I started approaching industry. I started grooming my students, preparing them conceptually. Used to sit in oral examination, though I am not nor internal, neither external examiner. Used to sit there, ask, fire. You have to fire like that. Then only in the year 2009, it went to 94%. See, 17% gone to 94%, it's a practical. Something must have been done, must have happened. Is it that I have performed in the interview? No. Same students. Is it that I have guided my students? No. Or same faculty. So this is how the things happen. You believe in the system, believe in the people, things will happen automatically. So, from that point of view, what we have done that last year, third year, after third year, whenever vacation was there, I made it mandatory to all my 300 students to register for the course. I said 1200 is a fee, 600 you have to pay from your pocket, 600 institution will pay. 1200, 200 hours training, and it is compulsory. If you are absent continuously for 5 days, you are rusticated from placement. Whatever company comes, you will not be allowed. You want to complain to anybody, go and complain. Everything was made clear. Students were compelled, even by taking 600 rupees. I said, go and complain to anybody that principal has started collecting money 600 rupees for no purpose, no problem. What happened? Next year, I didn't make anything compulsory. Not only fine the third year student, but second year student boys also joined the course, sir, we want to join. See, how you do it and how right way you do it, it all depends on all these things, right? So, this is that industry readiness, same pre-placement training. What is that? Our students are weak in soft skills. We know that communication skill, leadership skill, managerial skills, all these skills are mentioned somewhere here. Here it is, entrepreneurial skill, leadership, entrepreneurial, managerial, communication, collaborative skills and behavioral skills, cognitive skills, non-cognitive skills. Technically is okay, whatever is available is given to in the class that they have accepted, they have passed the examination, that means at least 40% they are okay as far as technical concepts are concerned. But they are very poor here. Such students, if suppose such training is given, they can also perform in CAT examination, they can also go for GRE and all these examinations, at least they get to know what is what. So, such a thing is there, such a beautiful thing. So, that is the industry readiness. NPIU has floated 3 tenders. I will let you know and you be a part of that. 3 tenders. Tender 1 is GET coaching. That means service provider will come to your institution and give GET coaching. This will happen next year because this examination is now just coming. So, next year GET training will be given to your students at the cost of project money and by the service provider who are country famous. Such 3-4 service providers we are going to empanel. This is point number 1. Second point, employability. This kind of training we are also identifying, empaneling some 5-6 service providers. Again same thing will happen. They will come in your institution sometime maybe in the month of March, April, moment the examinations are over. They will prepare your students for placement. Today, suppose 0 placement is there, at least 5% placement will happen, 10% placement will happen, gradually it will go, 17 reaching to 94 is not in one day, in 1 year, it will take little bit time. So, that is what industry readiness, if you are interested in that, take up that and just start working on this. Now, this is important for you, Swayam and Swayamprabha. Now, I will tell Swayamprabha. Swayamprabha, anybody know, aware about? What is that? TV, 32 TV channels, MHRD. Continuously some lectures are happening on different topics. If they are engineering, basically all engineering courses are delivered by IIT people. That is called as Swayamprabha. We have requested your principals to have 3-4 TVs displayed in different laboratories or library and continuously all the channels going on. If suppose student likes, yes, today some mathematics is going on, some partial differential, he will sit and just know, try to understand. Even faculty member can also sit, right? That is a Swayamprabha. Another is Swayam. Swayam is online portal. These are all certification programs. I would recommend you to register yourself for these programs. Whatever registration fees are there, charges are there, certification charges are there, they can be borne through project. Get those certificates. Say signals and system. You have studied signals and system because you are from electronics. But now you want to have certification with you. You can very much mention in your CV that your signals and system course is certified by Swayam. So there are many courses here also in Swayam, so that also you can take up. Revision of curriculum, people are talking about digital communication and analog communication. What should happen first? What should happen? I have heard from Professor Upadhyay. He told me, because these examples only I carry everywhere and just go on telling the same thing, right? So this is what you are. Yes, I'll take care that your university is properly instructed that this digital communication and what is that analog communication should have something like predecessor chain in place, right? So revision of curriculum is also there. This is already discussed. Accreditation, it is also mandatory. AICTE has come up with rule that if you want additional course, your course should be accredited. If you want additional intake, that particular course should be accredited. If you want PG, all your UG, corresponding UG course should be accredited. So everybody is now tightening the ropes. So probably, you know, this will make people apply for accreditation. So what all these accreditation will come with detailed guidelines, detailed procedure information. It is also available on NBA website. NBA chairman himself will be addressing on 8th. So that time also, you know, it will come automatically slowly to you. But it, you know, outcome based education is a buzzword. That important concept, terminology, you should remember in mind. But you can start working on this. You don't have vacation, you know, may be aware. You don't have summer vacation. Now students have gone, your senior faculty members have gone on leave. What will you do in the class, in the institution? Isn't it? That's a point. That's a point. Suppose you don't find any other opportunity, then what will you do? Yes, you can start working on this. See here. Documents. Teaching and learning process. Lab manuals. Lesson plans. Utilization study. See, moment unless you start working in that, you won't get experience. Please remember, my dear friend. No, my area is, my specialization is, say for example, what is that? IC engines or four stroke engines or combustion. Only I'll restrict myself to combustion. No, it's not life. Combustion will not help you to live your life. You have to start working, you have to change your habits, isn't it? Passion you have to just exploit, and accordingly you have to, you know, go ahead and progress. So this is accreditation. We have MOU with Stanford University for skill assessment of the students. So first test is already over. Next test is going to happen next year. So again, be a part of this test. Become a coordinator, department coordinator, or, you know, institute coordinator for this. This will get you a lot of experience. How the testing happens, what different tests are there, how the feedback is given, so on and so forth. So this is, now we come to KIT. What can you do in IIT? You should read left column, activities. KIT means, I told you, there are 10 IITs with whom we have understanding. All these 10 IITs are part of Knowledge Incubation TechU. Names of IITs, I think I have already told you, but still I will repeat. IIT Delhi, IIT Guwahati, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Bombay, IIT Hyderabad, IIT Indore, IIT Kanpur, IIT Gandhinagar, Hyderabad, or Madras, and one more, Roorkee, correct. So these are 10 IITs. Now whatever is nearer, wherever your specialization is there, wherever your interests are there, wherever your relatives, friends are staying, check it. What is that? These KIT activities consist of 13 points. It is available on website also, madam. It is available on website, no problem. My presentation probably will be given to you. Okay. First point is summer and winter internship for you. You know what is internship. You can spend 1 month in IIT. So now vacation is there. Summer vacation, you are worried what to do. My native place is say Andhra Pradesh. I will prefer Hyderabad so that Saturday, Sunday at least I can meet my parents. Suppose, find out your select area, approach the faculty. For approaching, you can directly approach TechCube coordinator, contact numbers are available on our website. IIT TechCube coordinator, like Professor Upadhyay here. Likewise, we have all these 10 TechCube coordinators. Through them, they can, you can contact, and if you find any difficulty, we are there. You just try to approach. First of all, even that TechCube coordinator would not be having that much of access to everybody. So, first of all, you have to meet the faculty. Sir, I want to do this. What he said that almost 100 faculty members are, they have been very happy to see you here. 100 faculty, he told me. That means at least you got 100 faculty members here. Find out your own area faculty. Start talking to him. Instead of spending time after this workshop, try to take his appointment and go there and start talking on every aspect. Come in next summer, register for the course and do this summer internship. This is the first point, 30 days. Now, in these 30 days, what you have to do? You have to pay only traveling allowance, TA, coming and going. Rest of the things will be borne by IIT. Stay arrangement, food, over. Now, question is that coming and going, that amount can be borne through project. So, therefore, naturally you have to take permission of your principal. You have to impress, that is what I said. You have been appointed by him, engagement letter is given by him. You have to impress him. Understood? He should also start realizing that yes, you are very important asset. For the institution, tomorrow I have to apply for accreditation, SAR is to be uploaded and he is a fellow who can help me. So, let us give him benefit, ask him to go there, right. So, all these things, this is first point. Second point is for student. Third point, now you have been given say UG project. Just try to see who is the faculty working in that area here. Start doing. See, research happens like this only. When I was doing my post graduation, that time M.Tech was not compulsory. I was doing my post graduation, preliminary setup establishment I had given as a project to my UG students. That time whosoever was guide for my post graduation was also guiding these 4 students. Try to understand, there is a link. Then I started doing my PhD, that time again I wanted to have some other setup, more refined setup. Same thing, again one project batch, UG project batch, who were working under the guidance of my guide for PhD. So, this is how the change should happen. Likewise, third point, identify the project, find out any other faculty from IIT, get him connected once, twice, thrice, 4 times, you know, it is a 1 year project. Hardly students work for 3 months, you know, you have done project. Only 3 months we finish that. In that 3 months, 2-3 times, you know, what is that? Discussion, interaction, that is enough. Understood? So, that is also possible. Fourth is not of your important, but fifth, collaborative research, this you can do. You know, provided you have identified a person, the faculty here, provided his area of interest and your area of interest is, provided you are also useful to him, so simple it is. It is a give and take policy, win-win situation. So, naturally, he should also realize that yes, you are also equally important, you have some additional knowledge, some additional area you can cover. It can be multidimensional, multidisciplinary also.
Can a PhD
PhD student cannot guide PhD.
No, I am saying if among T2 faculty, someone has PhD completed.
Yes.
Can he guide yes. PhD student officially?
Yes. Okay. For that, there is a procedure. You have to register with the society, I mean, with the university. University has got some guidelines. You have to fill up those forms, get recommendations also. Principal's recommendation is also necessary, and then submit that form to the university.
But they may say projects for 3 years, PhD may take 4 years. Then why will you go after 3 years?
I have not understood.
So I am there in this project for 3 years only, but PhD may take 4 or 5 years.
Registration of guide is not done on the basis of topic you are doing or the research area. It depends on your faculty. If you are from mechanical, so you will be registered in mechanical.
No, I want to guide, for example. Say, I am PhD. I want to guide a PhD student. Is there any provision in TQF scheme which allows me to guide PhD students?
After 3 years, you may not be with the same.
Not I doing PhD. So I have my PhD complete. I want to guide PhD students.
Yes.
So can I guide?
Yes.
After 3 years, he will have.
I have served 3 universities. Now you know me, so that is why I will just tell you in Maharashtra. Nagpur University during year 2082 to 1982 to 1995. Okay? Then served Amravati University 1996 to 1999. Then served Shivaji University, Kolhapur 99 to maybe some period. Then again came back to Amravati. Then again came back. I am still registered guide in all 3 universities. I left Nagpur University in the year 1994. Still I am a registered guide there. I can guide. If you want to register in Nagpur University, yes, I am a guide. Come here, my signature is valid. Have you understood the point? So, do not come now and then, no, do not remind yourself very frequently that you are contract, you are contract, you are contract. I told you I am also contract. I have not understood your question. Okay, right, okay. But this was collaborative research and it was not for guiding the, you know, faculty. I do not know how did you go there. Anyway, very good. We should use, you know, yeah.
Sir, he is asking that he has completed his PhD, then he can take PhD student under his supervision.
Yes? No, his question was something different. I was answering your question that time. Whatever answer was there, na, that time it was not applicable to him. It is now applicable to you. Whether you are doing contract, you are in industry or you are what, your university does not ask you. University has got clear cut 3-4, what is that, eligibility criteria. You have to go back to your university and check. For example, I tell you my own university criteria. My university says you should have PhD. Yes, I have PhD. My university says you should have these many publications. Yes, I have these publications. My university says you should have taught undergraduate students for those many years, or postgraduate students for these many years, or should have taken project of these students. This is a criteria of my university. I am telling you, go back to your university and check what is the eligibility criteria for registering yourself as a guide. Clear? Not clear? So, just come with me to Lucknow on the way, 2 hour journey.
Okay, sir. A quick question about 1 and 5. Say, if I find some institute, say IIC Bangalore, which is not in the list, so.
That is not possible.
But, I mean, stay they will provide. Okay. Then will TA, at least TADA provide?
Yes. TADA for your growth, everything is available there, except after 3 years continuation, I cannot ensure you now.
So this summer and winter internship from which?
And secondly, you have to mind first of all your students' benefits. Right.
And so
for summer and winter internship, from which date we can start? Suppose now we are having some leaves.
Vacation. Summer means summer, winter means winter, right? Summer starts sometime in the month of May. May to July, May to June. Now, your area is something different. You have leave now. So, you just check with this IIT whether these internship programs are going on. Normally, they have during this vacation only.
Do we have any casual leave?
Actually, right now…
Done. Array, so many things are there. Just… Yes. Let us go next. I have only 10-15 minutes now.
7 minutes.
So, quality circle we have already discussed. He has been discussing with you quality circle. It's a great idea. Serial number 10. And international national conferences you can organize in collaboration with IIT. IIT won't demand any money from you. Right? Then this is IIM's programs. Now, IIM's programs, they started announcing in Indian Institute of Management. There are 7 IIMs. That is also mentioned at the top. 7, 8. There are 8 IIMs. So, you please check their websites and check relevance of the training program. You don't need to pay any registration fees. No learning material will be, you know, free. Only you have to spend money on traveling, and traveling expenditure can be borne through project. And you gain all these things. You try to achieve all these points, try to participate and collect as many certificates, but with active participation, right? And what all those things are, that is mentioned here. This is, I skip now this, already discussed. This one also, and now this. Only 7 minutes we have got. Can we go fast?
Yes, sir.
What, why join project? In other words, what are the benefits of the project to you? I can take question here also, no problem. Why you should join the project? First of all, before that, we should understand this relationship. And then try avail benefits, what those benefits are. After availing these benefits, take this particular project, this position as a launching point. There was a question whether we will get experience certificate or not. What kind of temporary or this? We will give you clear experience certificate as a assistant professor. It will be continuation. For 3 years, 2 years, whatever time you serve, whatever time project is there, that particular certificate, and then it will be counted everywhere except NIT and IIT, because they have got their own criteria and they are INI, right? Everywhere we are going to issue some regulation, some notification from MHRD itself that it will be counted, because some people are claiming, actually these are rumors. There are many people, about 90% people in our society, who normally become very happy by spreading rumors. They don't know anything, but start to try to impress and spread. So that is what the situation is, right? So, you know, just understanding or realizing or say assuming that yes, these rumors are going to be true tomorrow. So just for anticipating those problems, we are going to issue that this will be considered. Now, what are these benefits? Please check this. First of all, very important thing is that you are a part of different academic reforms, which are every one of these academic reforms is a need-based demand of a day. All this, if you consider internship, how internship should be implemented. If you consider startup, if suppose startup program is to be initiated in one institution, you should try to acquire that particular experience, and tomorrow confidently should be able to say that yes, I can do that, I can take up this, I can motivate the students. So that is what academic reforms, many academic reforms say, for example, accreditation or autonomy, what not, induction program, what not. There are many academic reforms which are going to happen, and
the money required, the funds required will be admissible through the project. So, funds are available, laboratory is available, patients means students are available, now only the leader is required. So, that is what your job would be. Then you get exposure, you will get some, you know, something from research and also training. And this is very important. Every institution there are faculty like you at least from 3 states. So, heterogeneity. So, that is a very good character one should have, you know, world class institutes, our IITs, somebody sitting there IIT, nobody is there in 200, right? No, faculty. Nobody is there in 200. Why? Do you know? There are two reasons. Reason number one, that we do not have heterogeneity of faculty. Now, new IITs have started, but then they have only two. Say for example, IIT Indore, they have got Japanese faculty and Indian faculty. Heterogeneity, we need to have foreign faculty. You know what is happening in foreign universities? Our own faculty, our own students take degree from there. That is the only difference. Rest of the things the same. So, many faculty members from China, from India and so many Asian countries, other countries, they are there in US. Similarly, this is one. Second one is again heterogeneity of the students. We have in our institutions students from only from our district, sometimes in the state, not beyond. That is a problem. So, first thing what has happened because of your engagement is this diversity. Then these are the guidelines. I think now I take your questions. There was some question about leaves. Leave, this is that leave. In one quarter, 5 days. Means in 1 year, 20 days. 20 days leave, no more than that. Any leave beyond that will be leave without pay, but it has to be reported to principal. Second, any leave below that will be accumulated, but till the end of financial year. These leaves, it is mentioned in your engagement letter that these are study leave. Study leave does not mean that coming for this workshop. For such workshops, you do not need to take any leave. Study leave means I have mentioned in bracket. Where is that? Somewhere I have mentioned? Oh, I have forgotten. Engagement letter. So, it is for medical reason, you are casual, this and that. Now, any question about leave?
Sir, when we got a document written that you will get vacations according to AICT oblique institute rules.
No.
So, if right now, nobody is there in our Islamic university. So, even if we go, we cannot proceed any work.
No vacation.
But some departments have given some, they are set that they have nothing to do.
I don't know. I will ask your department.
Okay.
Who is getting benefit? Let us not blame him. Let us not claim that.
Okay.
Because he is getting illegal benefits, I should also get. This you can do with your father. One son is getting and another son is not getting. Yes, you can start quarreling, no problem. Yes, please.
Sir, you have told me very effective DLIs, etc. But when we come into the evaluation part, you will evaluate the faculty members on the basis of their performance. And other institutions like DIT Mitra and MIT Gwalior, these are well equipped institutions. And Chhapra is not well equipped. Even some basic amenities we are not getting, such like computer, internet facility, water cooler, sitting arrangement, and etc. I have written in this paper and signed by.
For faculty or students?
For faculty.
Sir, but it may be a change in their life sir, once the faculty will not be settled,
my SPIU, just a minute, which state you belong? Bihar. Bihar mein SPIU abhi bhi unko room nahi mila hai. Bihar mein SPA kal aa rahe hain join hone, state project administrator, aur SPIU mein do log hai, do clerk hai aur do log, ye charo log kahan baithte hain? suniye, aisa hi hota hai. When it is a beginning, ye aisa hi hota hai. Because these people thought that, you know, they are getting faculty. They were happy, but they have not prepared for accommodating the faculty. This is a problem with your institute. Right. So gradually, just have patience. You have submitted to me. I will WhatsApp just now. Just a minute. I will WhatsApp just now on Bihar State Unit. Bihar State Unit, all institutions, all principals of Bihar, all TechCube coordinator of Bihar are there on that WhatsApp group. Now only after while going back, I will just take photographs and WhatsApp. Let all institutions in Bihar know what is the situation of Chhapra. One. Second, tomorrow I will write to your principal secretary of Bihar. And Atul Sinha, on return only I will call him. What is this? Okay, only the thing is that no, you, one thing you do, you remove your signatures from here. Signature wala bhi rehne do, mere paas ye bhi rehne do. Theek hai, badhiya. Chalo.
I have a question regarding this online course.
Haan, second question.
Sir, jo hum log ka TechU grant ka jo installment aaya tha 3 crore ka, wo wapas chala gaya without koi purchasing. To sir,
koi nahi gaya paisa, wo TechU 2 ki baat kar rahe hain aap. टेक्यूब 2 की बात है, आप बात ही क्यों कर रहे हो? टेक्यूब 2 कोई टेक्यूब 3 का वापस नहीं गया, वहीं पे दिया है. हाँ, ये आपने बहुत बार सवाल पूछ लिया, उनको भी जवाब. यस. हाँ हाँ सी विल देयर की बात नहीं करिए आप. आपकी इंस्टीट्यूशन के स्टूडेंट्स को बेनिफिट मिलने के बाद में भी अगर आप टाइम मिल रहा है तब आप करिए ये. आई टोल्ड यू सो मेनी टाइम्स दैट यू आर अपॉइंटेड फॉर द स्टूडेंट, नॉट फॉर यूर सेल्फ. प्लीज रिमेंबर, यू हैव टू ग्रो विद द ग्रोथ ऑफ, नॉट विथ यूर सेल्फ. स्टूडेंट्स विल नॉट ग्रो विथ यूर ग्रोथ एज ऑफ नाउ टूडे. लॉन्ग टर्म ठीक है, मेरा मेरे स्टूडेंट को फायदा, मेरा आज आपको फायदा होना चाहिए यहां पे. मैं तो मेरा तो फायदा हो गया है, आया ना समझ में? आई एम ट्राइंग टू यूटिलाइज माई टाइम इफेक्टिवली फॉर यू ओनली, है ना? तो उसके बाद में जो भी पॉसिबल है वो सारा बता दिया मैंने आपको. अप्रोच योर प्रिंसिपल, टेक योर परमिशन इफ ही एग्रीज. अब ये कह रहे हैं ना कि कोई किसी डिपार्टमेंट ने वैकेशन दे दिया, हमें नहीं दिया. हो सकता है वैसा कुछ हुआ हो, वो फैकल्टी ने बहुत उनके डिपार्टमेंट को बहुत मेहनत करके कुछ तो भी कर दिया है. अरे क्या चीज? cpa.npiu. सी बेसिकली यू आर अपॉइंटेड बाय योर इंस्टीट्यूट. हमने तो केवल फैसिलिटेट किया, योर प्रिंसिपल ने अपॉइंट करा है, है ना? तो मैं ये कह रहा हूं कि यू हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट योर इंस्टीट्यूट, यू हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट योर प्रिंसिपल, यू हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट पॉलिसीज ऑफ योर इंस्टीट्यूट. ऐसा नहीं है, थोड़ा सा सोच के देखिए, सोच के देखिए आप.
ऑनलाइन लर्निंग,
दिस इज द एप्लीकेशन प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल ऑफ फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड दीस आर द पॉइंट्स वी वुड लाइक टू मेंशन एंड डिस्कस्ड. एक्चुअली नंबर ऑफ पीपल.
बैठो, मैं पढ़ू क्या? ये चार पॉइंट्स पढ़ू क्या? बैठिए. हाँ सुनिए भाई, ये देर आर फोर क्वेश्चंस. वी आर रनिंग आउट ऑफ टाइम. देर आर फोर क्वेश्चंस. परमिशन टू परस्यू PhD इन पार्ट टाइम, इट इज परमिटेड? विच प्रिंसिपल आई हैव टू राइट? टेल मी, आई विल राइट लेटर टू द प्रिंसिपल दैट प्लीज इश्यू नो ऑब्जेक्शन सर्टिफिकेट वेन एवर रिक्वायर्ड, वेर एवर रिक्वायर्ड, प्रोवाइडेड यूर रेगुलर एकेडमिक्स डजंट सफर. वेरी सिंपल, मैंने आपको बता दिया है और ये लिख भी दिया है. जहाँ से मुझे मेल आई वहाँ पे मैंने लिख भी दिया है, किसी प्रिंसिपल ने ही मुझे पूछा कि हमारे लोग बोल रहे हैं कि एनओसी दो क्या, और परसों के प्रेजेंटेशन में प्रिंसिपल को बता दिया है मैंने, अभी आपको दिखाऊं मैं, मेरा लैपटॉप नहीं लगा है, उनको मैंने क्या क्या बताया है वो सारा बता दिया है कि आपने क्या क्या करना है क्या क्या नहीं करना है. सेकेंड पॉइंट इज इट पॉसिबल टू हैव सम सीट्स फॉर टेक्यू फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एट इंस्टीट्यूट्स अंडर टेक्यू 3. हाँ ये करेंगे हम, कुछ तो करेंगे इसके बारे में. मतलब ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट सम इंस्टीट्यूशंस नॉन फोकस मेंटर इंस्टीट्यूशंस जहाँ पे पीएचडी क्यूआईपी चलता है या पीएचडी चलता है वहाँ पे ये फोकस इंस्टीट्यूशंस की फैकल्टी के लिए पीएचडी के लिए सीटें रखो, बराबर है ना. काइंड्स ऑफ लीव्स वी आर एंटाइटल, दिस इज एक्सप्लेन आई थिंक. इफ पॉसिबल एंड सीट्स आर वैकेंट काइंडली गिव अस चांस टू वर्क एट द इंस्टीट्यूट नियरेस्ट टू अवर. ये नहीं, ये देखेंगे सोचेंगे, चलो नेक्स्ट.
ऑनलाइन लर्निंग यू सेड वाज स्वयं, कैन यू रिमेंबर्स इफ यू डू ऑनलाइन लर्निंग फ्रॉम अदर लाइक कोर्सेरा इज देयर.
हां
ओके. एंड इंटरनेशनल फंड इफ वी हैव अ कॉन्फ्रेंस आउटसाइड इंडिया.
सुनो जस्ट अ मिनट, अभी नाउ सम रिसर्चर्स अमंग्स यू दे आर ऑलवेज आस्किंग मी अबाउट इंटरनेशनल ग्रांट. आई वांट टू गो अब्रॉड फॉर अटेंडिंग कॉन्फ्रेंस. नो प्रॉब्लम, यू शुड गो अब्रॉड. प्लीज चेक गाइडलाइंस, इंटरनेशनल ट्रैवल गाइडलाइंस. दैट डॉक्यूमेंट इज अवेलेबल ऑन अवर वेबसाइट. इट इज नॉट ओनली अप्लीकेबल टू यू बट ऑल्सो एवरी फैकल्टी मेंबर इंक्लूडिंग प्रिंसिपल एंड मी ऑल्सो, दैट माई कैटेगरी शुड फॉल इन वन ऑफ दोज टू. वन इज प्लेनरी सेशन, यू शुड बी इन्वाइटेड बाय फॉर कीनोट. सेकेंड यूर पब्लिकेशन, फॉर दैट साइटेशन, इम्पैक्ट फैक्टर, दिस एंड दैट. So that document is there, you fill up that document, get certified from your principal, start process 3 months before. Yes.
And it cannot be like, even if it is an invited paper, not a plenary at all. So if I get
invited. Check it from there. Yes, next. Kya cheez? Kaun sa engagement? Engagement is... चलो भाई, थैंक यू. एनीथिंग एनी इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यू? ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच.